Vote in the House of Representatives scheduled next week on raising the debt ceiling, meaning there would not be any spending cuts if this were to pass, which of course it's not expected to do. So why waste the time with this test vote? Here now, Republican Florida Congressman Dennis Ross. Congressman Ross, welcome to Freedom Watch. It's a pleasure to have you.
Thank you, Judge. It's a pleasure to be here.
Tell us what's going to happen next week. Is there going to be some simple, basic yay or nay on whether or not to authorize the Treasury Secretary to raise the debt ceiling by going out and borrowing more money, putting us into debt deeper than the $14.3 trillion with no strings attached to it whatsoever? Is that what the House is going to do next week?
If it's a straight up and down vote, it's my prediction that it'll fail. We've got to use this opportunity to make sure that we get our house in order. I am not convinced that we need to raise our debt ceiling. I'm very convinced that we need to use it to get our house in order. I mean, think about it, Judge. We are trying to raise our debt ceiling because we can't pay our debt. Who would buy our debt and at what rates then? I mean, are we not creating this debt spiral in terms of our financial state if we continue to raise our debt ceiling and yet you do nothing to bring in our cost containment?
Congressman Ross, I could not agree more with what you just said and with the very elegant and compelling way in which you said it. Will John Boehner say that on the floor of the House, or will he cut some kind of a deal with the President and the Treasury Secretary and Harry Reid over in the Senate and try and talk the rest of you into going along with it?
Well, I have a lot of faith in our speaker. I think John Boehner is the right person at the right time. And I know that we have to address this crisis. But what can we get in return for it? Can we get some spending cuts that allow that the spending will not exceed 15 to 18% of GDP? Can we get a balanced budget amendment? You know, there are some very significant things in there that we could possibly do that might allow us the opportunity to consider raising the debt ceiling so that we can get beyond and get our house in order. You know, Judge, the important thing is we don't get our house in order. Those creditors of the United States right now will fail miserably if we default in the long term.
Do you think that most of your colleagues, your Republican colleagues in the House, agree with you? Stated differently, if there's no balanced budget amendment sent to the states, and quite frankly, I don't think the numbers are there for that to happen. Will Republicans in the House vote no? Because if they vote no, this never even gets to the Senate. The president has to run the government just on the $250 billion a month he collects in income taxes.
Right. And actually, that might not be a bad thing. I mean, consider it. It would force us to pay our interest only so that we make sure that those that are creditors of the United States are at least getting their return in terms of interest. And then it would force us to have to prioritize essential government functions. It's something we should have done a long time ago, but to have to do it now because we are at a stalemate and won't raise the debt ceiling, quite frankly, might be a silver lining for this country. It may be some pain, but I'd rather have the pain in the short term than a very long-term catastrophe of a debt failure.
Will you, Congressman Dennis Ross of the great state of Florida, pledge to vote against raising the debt ceiling unless there's a balanced budget amendment passed first?
I will tell you right now, I'm not convinced to vote for the debt ceiling. I would love to see a balanced budget amendment passed first, but I don't think that's going to happen, as you pointed out. Does that mean that there aren't some other matters in there that could be handled that would satisfy the necessary spending cuts that need to go into place? I hope so, and I think that's what's on the table. But right now, I am not convinced that raising the debt ceiling is the right thing to do.
Congressman Ross, it's a pleasure. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Judge, for allowing me.
Of course. Medicare reform has morphed into Mediscare.